This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. SteamOS is a Debian-based Linux operating system in development by Valve Corporation, designed to be the primary operating system for the Steam Machine video game consoles. It was initially released on December 13, 2013, alongside the start of end-user beta testing of Steam Machine's contents 1 features 2 history 21 releases 3 performance 4 reception 5 see also 6 references 7 external links features. SteamOS is designed primarily for playing video games in the living room by providing a console-like experience using generic PC hardware. It can run games natively that have been developed for Linux and purchased from the Steam Store. Users are also able to stream games from their Windows, Mac or Linux computers to one running SteamOS, and it incorporates the same family sharing and restrictions as Steam on the desktop. Valve claims that it has achieved significant performance increases in graphics processing through SteamOS. The operating system is open source, allowing users to build on or adapt the source code, though the actual Steam client is closed since SteamOS is solely for playing games in the living room. It does not have many built-in functions beyond web browsing and playing games. For example, there is no file manager or image viewer installed by default. Users can, however, access the available GNOME desktop environment and perform tasks like installing other software, though the OS does not, in its current form, support streaming services. Valve is in talks with streaming companies such as Spotify and Netflix to bring their features to SteamOS. However, Steam does have full-length films from indie movie makers available from their store. The OS natively supports NVIDIA, Intel, and AMD graphics processors. Valve stated that it has added support for movies, television, and music functionality to SteamOS. However, the video content is only from Steam Store, which has a small amount of films, while music playback only supports local music collections. In October 2015, an update allowed Netflix and other DRM-protected content to function in the native built-in browser. The current system hardware requirements for default SteamOS installations include Intel or AMD 64-bit capable processor, 4 GB or more RAM, 200 GB or larger hard disk, NVIDIA Fermi graphics cards or newer, Intel or AMD graphics card, Radeon HD 5XXX or newer, USB port for installation, UEFI boot support. A custom installer method is also available, which can require additional configuration steps. This method allows for smaller hard disk sizes. There is also an ISO image installer that supports legacy BIOS motherboard. The installers can be sourced through Valve's repository history. During a panel at LinuxCon in 2013, Valve co-founder and executive director Gabe Newell stated that he believed Linux and open source are the future of gaming, though his beliefs about games themselves being open source is unclear, going on to say that the company is aiding game developers who want to make games compatible with Linux, and that they would be making an announcement the following week related to introducing Linux into the living room. On September 20, 2013, Valve posted a statement on its website titled "The Steam Universe is expanding in 2014, which teased 3 new announcements from them related to even more ways to connect the dots for customers who want Steam in the living room. The first announcement was revealed on September 23 as SteamOS, with Valve saying they had come to the conclusion that the environment best suited to delivering value to customers is an operating system built around Steam itself. A large focus of the reveal was the openness of the operating system, with it being announced that users would be able to alter or replace any part of the software, and that it would be free. In October 2013, Valve announced Steam Dev Days, a 2-day developer conference where video game developers will be able to test and provide feedback on SteamOS and Steam Machines. In October 2013, NVIDIA also announced their collaboration with Valve to support SteamOS with the help of a development suite called NVIDIA GameWorks, which incorporates PHYSX, optics, Visual FX and other NVIDIA proprietary APIs and implementations thereof. In November 2013, Valve confirmed that they would not be making any exclusive games for SteamOS, and were also encouraging other developers not to, as it goes against their philosophy of selling games wherever customers are. In December, Valve announced that a beta version of SteamOS would be released for download on December 13, 2013. When this beta version released, Valve suggested waiting until 2014 to use it unless the user was confident using Linux operating systems. In mid-October 2015, pre-orders of the Steam Controller, Steam Link, and Alienware-branded Steam Machines became available. The official release date for Steam Machines was on November 10, 2015. Releases release codename base distribution SteamOS changes SteamOS 10 Alchemist Debian 7 Wheezy SteamOS 20 Brewmaster Debian 8 Jesse various third-party drivers and updated graphics stack updated kernel tracking the 41 long-term branch custom graphics compositor auto update from the Valve SteamOS repository. Performance in December 2013, Foranix compared three NVIDIA graphics cards on SteamOS and Windows 81 overall. The NVIDIA's proprietary Linux graphics driver can deliver comparable performance to that of the Windows drivers due to the largely shared code base between the platforms. In January 2014, GameSpot compared the performance to games running on Windows using identical hardware and settings with an AMD graphics card and a NVIDIA graphics card on the AMD graphics card. They found that Dota 2, Left 4 Dead 2 and Metro, Last Light all ran at considerably fewer frames per second under SteamOS. Left 4 Dead 2 also suffered from stuttering, which they attributed to a device driver problem on the NVIDIA graphics card. Metro, Last Light ran at slightly higher frames per second, and Dota 2 ran at the same rate. They state that for Left 4 Dead 2 the NVIDIA card actually performed better under SteamOS, but did not specify how, as their chart indicated it performed at a lower frame rate on both cards. Left 4 Dead 2 and Dota 2 both had longer load times compared to Windows. On the official release of Steam Machines in November 2015, Ars Technica compared the rendering performance of cross-platform games on SteamOS and Windows 10 running on the same machine, using average frame per second measurements, and found that games were rendered between 21% and 58% slower on SteamOS compared to Windows 10. Ars Technica considered this might be due to the inexperience of developers optimizing on OpenGL in contrast to DirectX, and believed that the performance might improve with future titles. Ars Technica noted that its benchmark, comprising only 6 games on a single computer, was far from comprehensive. Games designed with OpenGL and Linux in mind might run faster than their Windows counterparts. In fact, benchmarking by Foranix showed Ubuntu 15.04 outclassing Windows 10 when running FreeLibre Quake clone OpenArena. The primary tests of the Foranix benchmarks were OpenArena, Zonautic, and GPUdist. In OpenArena and in the synthetic GPUdist, Ubuntu 15.04 was marginally faster than Windows 10 for each of the several graphics cards tested. However, Windows 10 did much better than Ubuntu 15.04 for Zonautic V08 reception on the gaming front. Following the initial announcement, many video game developers have shared their thoughts on SteamOS. Minecraft creator Marcus Persson described it as amazing news, and Thomas Was Alone developer Mike Bithell called it encouraging for indie games. Other developers such as DICE, creators of the Battlefield series, and the Creative Assembly, developers of the Total War series, have stated that they may support their games on Linux and SteamOS on the operating system front. Gearbox Software head Randy Pitchford commented that he believed the operating system needed a unique application to attract developers, saying, "Without that must-buy product driving us all towards this stuff, I expect that the industry at large will watch curiously, but remain largely unaffected." Richard Stallman, head of the Free Software Foundation, is cautiously supportive, although he does not condone the use of non-free games or DRM. The SteamOS beta release received mixed reviews. In TechRadar's review, Henry Winchester praised the easy-to-navigate interface and future potential, but criticized the hard installation and lack of extra features compared to the Steam software. Eurogamer's Thomas Morgan did not incur installation problems, however commented negatively on the lack of options available for detecting monitor resolutions and audio output and the lack of games available natively on the operating system. He did, however, also respond positively to the user interface and called it a positive start. Since then, outlets such as Ars Technica have revisited the SteamOS since its initial debut, offering observations on the platform's growth, pros, and cons. Both Falcon Northwest and Origin PC, computer manufacturers that were planning on offering Steam Machine hardware, opted to not ship a SteamOS-enabled machine in 2015 due to limitations of SteamOS over Windows. Falcon Northwest have said they will still consider shipping machines with SteamOS in the future if performance improves. See also Video Games Portal Free Software Portal Linux Portal Linux Gaming References Carrot SteamOS Retrieved December 12, 2013 Beta Early Build Your Own System Requirements Ars Technica Retrieved December 15, 2013 Carrot Vandel, Perry, September 16, 2013. Gabe Newell, Linux and Open Source Are the Future of Gaming. PC Gamer retrieved September 25, 2013. Carrot Hollister, Sean, December 11, 2013. Steamos will be available to download on December 13. The Verge retrieved December 11, 2013. Carrot Orland, Kyle, November 13, 2015. Steamos Gaming performs significantly worse than Windows. AR's analysis shows. AR's Technica retrieved November 16, 2015. GNU, Linux, Mukhtware Web Magazine, Mukhtware retrieved May 1, 2014. Blue Shift Decay Half-Life 2 Deathmatch Lost Coast Episode 1 Episode 2 Portal 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 2 Counter-Strike Counter-Strike Condition Zero Source Global Offensive Day of Defeat Day of Defeat Source Team Fortress Team Fortress Classic Team Fortress 2 Left 4 Dead Left 4 Dead Left 4 Dead 2 Other Deathmatch Classic Ricochet The Orange Box Alien Swarm Dota 2 The Lab Technology Hardware Steam Controller Steam Machine HTC Vive Software Gold's RC Mods Source Filmmaker Mods Steam Games Using Steam Authentication Steamos Valve Anti-Cheat People Current Mike Ambinder Zachary Barth Doug Church Jess Cliff Chet Falishik Icefrog Sam Lantinga Mike Morosky Gabe Newell J. Pinkerton Robin Walker Eric Wolpa Former Michael Abrash Kelly Bailey Mike Harrington Mark Laidlaw Min LeBay Rate Kim Swift Book Category VE Linux Distributions Arch Linux Antergos Archbang Chakra Manjaro Linux Parabola GNU Linux Libre Debian Antix Astra Linux Barat Operating System Solutions Devuan GNU Sense Handy Linux Kali Linux Nopic Sparkle Linux Steamos Tails Ubuntu Official Edubuntu Kubuntu Lubuntu Ubuntu Mate Zubuntu Unofficial Bodhi Linux Elementary OS Linux Mint Trisquel Fedora Blag Linux and New Corora Red Hat Enterprise Linux CentOS Kleros Linpus Linux Oracle Linux Cubes OS ROX Cluster Distribution Scientific Linux SME Server Gentoo Linux Calculate Linux Chromium OS Chrome OS Funtu Linux Sabayan Linux Other Asterix Frugalware Linux Mandriva Linux Magia OpenMadriva LX Rosa Linux OpenSUSE SUSE Linux Enterprise Server PC Linuxos Puppy Linux Slackware Porteus Salix OS Vector Linux Source Mage Category Comparison List Commons VE Debian Software in the Public Interest General Debkif Debian Free Software Guidelines Debian Social Contract Project Leaders Releases People B. Dale Garby John Gertzen Benjamin Mako Hill Sam Hachever Ian Jackson Martin Michelmeyer Ian Murdoch Jonathan Oxer Bruce Perrin Scott James Remnant Stefano Zaccaroli Derivatives Kernels Debian NU, Herd Debian NU, KFREEBSD Debian Pure Blend Forks Devuan Linux Mint Debian Edition Ubuntu Operating System Software Apt Aptitude Debugs Debkif Debian Installer DPKG Deb Win32 Loader Miscellaneous Mozilla Software Rebranded by Debian. Category Commons Wikiversity